Finally. How long was I working on that? Damn, that long. No wonder my back is killing me. Okay. Let's go see what my girl's been up to. Looks like she's still in the living room.
It comes as Matt Hancock's decision to make face coverings compulsory in hospitals for all staff, visitors, and outpatients.
Honey?
From June 15th.
This was you're still watching that.
Notice or consultation. A furious
did you even move?
Medical and
have you had anything to eat or drink?
The health secretary announced last night.
That can't be good. Do you feel sick? The sort of face coverings you should have told me if that was
but the move has
what's the matter? In the health service. Hey, Hobson, CEO of any why are you crying?
The government of rushing decisions.
Come here.
Said we're overly influenced by politics and the need to control space at the downside.
Yes, you are. I can see your eyes watering. And your shoulders are so stiff.
According to a tally here. Filed by Reuters,
let me rub them a little.
30% are in the US and 15% in Latin America. The global death toll is now approaching 400,000. This means in just 5 months, the coronavirus has killed almost as many people as the number who die annually from malaria. One of the world's most deadly infectious diseases.
There. Is that any better?
My colleague, Richard Orange, has spoken to Anders Tegnell, Sweden's state epidemiologist.
And tell me. Of the country's less restrictive what's bothering you so much that you've lost your appetite?
He appeared to admit flaws in his approach. Here's an extract of the interview, in which Tegnell doubled down and said with confidence.
That bad, huh?
To the virus. You can read the full story online. The 76th anniversary of the
sweetheart
has been marked with a socially distanced ceremony as the graves.
Why didn't you just turn the TV off if it was making you this upset?
The 75th anniversary commemorations. This year's resembles.
I can understand that, love, but it's hurting you.
Social distancing requirements and travel
I'm sorry, I didn't realize how stressed you were.
Forced to honor the fallen from afar on Saturday. The Commonwealth War Graves Commission said no more than 20 people, including the British ambassador to Edward Lewin.
That's enough, though. No more watching, listening, or reading the news today, okay?
CWGC spokesman Peter Francis said it
was no, I'm serious. I'm turning this TV off. Event, which saw there. Come on now. Snuggle up to me, buttercup. Here. Nice and tight in my arms. That's okay. I've got you. You're really tense, though. I know the situation sounds really bad in general, but I promise you, it's not going to last forever. Look at me. Come on, darling, look at me. Please. Now, listen to me. The whole world is fighting off this virus. We're going to find a cure and a vaccine soon enough. And once we do, things will slowly go back to normal. I know, honey. I know that it won't be easy. This pandemic has taken its toll on all of us, in one way or another, but we can fight through it. You can fight through it. You're strong, and you've done everything you could to stay healthy. Now, all there is to do is wait, darling. Oh, sweetheart. I also wish it was already over. But you need to be patient. And you need to stop watching the news so much. We do need to keep track of what's going on, but that doesn't mean that we should spend our time worrying about every new development. Why don't you watch a movie instead? Or how about starting a new project? maybe you could start up one of your old hobbies again. See? There's plenty to do. Especially while we wait for some good news. But now, lay down with me for a moment. There we go. Put your head on my chest, darling. I know you like it when I play with your hair. Dear. That's it. Relax into me. And now, I want you to focus on your breathing. Trust me, it'll help calm you down. Breathe with me. And out. That's it. In. And out. In. There. Are you feeling a little better? That's good. I'm glad I could help. No. Let's stay like this for a few more minutes. Then we'll go make something to eat before doing something fun together. Sounds good. Good.